Rutgers.
Yeah,
Rutgers,
they all go together.
Rutgers will win tonight, 24-17. I guarantee it. And I'll put up something against Fez on this one.
Let's see. You'll stay away from your wife for 2 weeks? No, you're a liar. Your bets can't be fucking gauged. And neither can Watley.
Well, I don't mind betting. I'll do hair versus hair on this thing.
Okay.
You've got a mohawk. Of course you want to shave your head. That would be like you getting a present. I'd be like, all right, loser gets a milkshake. And you have no hair, Dave.
What if I shave body hair? I will shave all of my body hair. You can check my
you
privates.
Should do that. You disgusting
Why?
Fuck, because you're growing red, nappy hair.
How about waxing?
Wax him?
Yeah. Look at his chest. This should be
okay,
up.
Mr. Bankton, $250. I will go to the bank right now and get $250 to
I don't pass. Need your $250.
That's true. Him losing $250 is nothing. That's like saying, all right, take the pocket lint out and hand it to the other person. He's got fucking more money in his pocket than lint right now. Queer Eye is not worried about $250.
All right. I've always wanted to watch Indiana
Queer
Jones
Eye.
With Fez. What if I win, if Rutgers wins, he has to come over to my house and watch an Indiana Jones trilogy with me. I'll make popcorn. He has to do that the whole night. How about that? That's good.
If you guys want to do this, do it on your own time, because no one listening to this show cares about either one of you or your two bets. Am I right about that, Earl?
Yes, you are.
Now, Earl, 99% of the time goes against me. Right? To back me up there.
Thanks, Earl.
Right.
I'm just as confident that Rutgers will win as I am that Fez is going away in 6 months.
All right, what about,
you're an asshole.
Wait a minute. Let's do this. Whoever loses, because you're both sick people,
okay,
has to spend the weekend in a mental health facility. A mental health facility. Because I know this. Look how Johnny, look. They're both red-faced and scared to death.
I don't like it.
I know.
We're not getting out.
Once that door fucking locks, they ain't getting out. Neither one of you. Neither one of you.
We're not going to leave.
I can feel the straitjacket tightening now.
You really, both of you need it.
I'm claustrophobic. I think my mental space is pretty fine. I feel...
You thought you got confused between girlfriend and mother.
All right.
That's the classic mental illness of all time.
That's true.
Freud built a fucking empire on the fact that little boys want to bang their mom. The fact that it's 29-year-old men, he would be stunned.
All right.
You would make Freud throw up. That's how disgusting you are.
It's something I have to work on, certainly, but it's something that I don't think I should be...
To get out of your mind?
I don't think I need to be an inpatient for.
So this is a little scarier to you than shaving your body hair or whatever.
Yeah.
Very much. I don't like that.
Claustrophobia.
Earl, which one of them needs to be kept in a mental institution?
I would have to go with Fez right now.
Yes! I am more sane than Fez, and I am fucking
so
proud.
You don't care that you made me cry yesterday. You're trying to do it again.
That goes to show that you're mental. You know what I love about this show? The executive producer never gets any respect. Zero respect for the executive producer. Everybody that's executive producer on this show ends up being with like that mean little girl from Kid Nation.
I
deal
said
with it.
Last week, I'll say it again, and I hate to call a 9-year-old a bitch, but I will. She is a bitch.
That's why you're going to end up in a mental institution.
I hate her so much.
Is it wrong to sit there and watch that show and just root against a 9-year-old girl?
Yeah. You're both sick people.
And just hope bad things happen to her at Kid Nation?
This is why you're the two that need to be locked up. Shake hands. Loser gets locked into a mental health facility this weekend.
I don't want to shake hands to that.
Don't you believe in USF?
Yes, I believe in USF, and I think they'll win. I know they'll win.
Then shake hands. And if you believe it, risk the mental health place.
It's too scary.
Yeah, that's
honestly, not... I think you'd be getting the help that you need. Outpatient is not working for you, Fez. This is going on for a lot of years.
Yeah, I mean, it's,
You need but a dart in your neck, and you need to be fucking strapped to a bed. Let the hallucinations come and go. Let it run through your mind. And then finally, on the other side of it, you're going to be fine. What are you scared about?
Sounds awful.
Jesus what are you scared Christ. About, Dave? I was talking to Fez.
I know, but just the dart was creeping
you
me
both
out.
Belong in there. Fez probably a little more than you because you have Casey, and he's on his own.
No, I can't. I couldn't do that.
But what if you came out better?
Because I can't.
What if you came back like this? Hi, everybody. Dave McDonald. Nice to see you. I'm ready to make a go of it.
I'd just be too scared. I want to change. I don't want to change, I don't think.
When it's time to change, you've got to rearrange. The Brady Six put it best.
Yeah. It's a good song. But I don't know. I just think that I feel like I would be held there against my will for quite some time. And I want to be here with you guys.
That sounds like a mental fucking patient. I want to be here with you guys.
I would never be able to calm down an impatient.
You belong there, though, dude. You're not. It's not working for you on the outside. Right. You've been in, on and out of so many fucking drugs right now. It's sometimes doing the show, you go away for hours at a time. And then I go, what's up? And you start crying. It's not what you expect a man to do. You need deep, deep, deep therapy. You need shock therapy.
See, I wouldn't be able to do it.
Wait, before you say anything, they put something in your mouth so you don't bite your tongue off.
Ew.
You get to bite down on that rubber thing in your mouth.
I know, but that's going to taste terrible. I had to have one of those at the dentist one time.
That's a dental dam. That's a whole different thing. And what you were tasting was your own breath.
They don't put fluoride in the things in mental hospitals.
All right, so shake hands. Loser goes into a mental fucking resort. Mental resort. It's like a spa where your brain is getting massaged.
I don't want anyone touching my brain, Mr. Bennington.
There, you'll be lucky if they find yours. That fucking pea brain of yours is going to be hiding.
Nah, I can't
Earl,
do that.
Do you have plans with your girlfriend this weekend? Pops. No.
I was invited to a party this weekend.
Black party?
No, not a black party. A birthday party.
Whose birthday party?
A friend of ours.
Am I invited?
You're invited.
Are they in the mafia? Yeah.
You're invited, but this person didn't want their birthday plans on the air.
Oh, great. What night?
Saturday.
Is it Donnie Brasco? Why a friend of ours?
It's a good fella. It's a good fella. Now, is this... Are we talking about baby girl? Is that hers this weekend?
No.
When's hers? I can't keep up with all the adult birthdays.
I'm not sure.
Too many adult birthdays.
All right, where is it?
Where do you think?
Oh, always.
I don't know who it is. I don't know.
That sounds like you're not invited.
Yeah, I didn't hear you when I was getting invited and they were telling me to pass it along to Ronnie, please. And Earl was getting invited. I didn't hear your name
well,
come up.
Whoever it is, he's a jerk.
Oh, maybe it's not a he.
She's a bitch.
Oh, I love it.
Please, go on.
Keep going. Go on one of your rants here. God. So I want to blow
it out. And let me know when I should reveal.
Would you just use the C word?
No, yeah, I don't know
who
it is.
Said,
I don't know
he used
who
the
is.
C word. Let me flip
this?
The card.
Who is this? No, I did not mean that.
Let
I
me flip
not.
The card.
I thought it was going to be someone else. I didn't know who it was. I
mental.
Did not.
You're a fucking mental. Wouldn't you feel better in a mental institution?
Yes.
Now you have the perfect excuse.
Bury me alive.
I know he said the word cunt, but he was already.
Didn't say that. I didn't
I
know.
Heard it.
You yelled, bury me alive.
They don't do that in a mental institution.
Yes, I am your doctor. Listen, we're going to bury him alive over the weekend, and by the time we dig him back up, he should be fine.
Everyone knows that I didn't know who was on the card. I did not know. I had a feeling like it was going to be
someone
of lesser importance.
We'll see when you're in the mental institution buried alive. You can lay there in your mental coffin thinking about it. Now, Fez, did you have the same feeling that you get buried alive? You fucking two are the two sickest. Now, here's the difference, though, Fez. He's happy mental. you're sad mental.
Right, yeah.
Like, he's like mental, like the movie Harvey. He's like Jimmy Stewart in Harvey, where he sees a big rabbit, but he's having drinks and he's meeting people and he's on adventures. Where you're back in your apartment paranoid and fucking weirded out. And thinking everybody's out to get you. You should have seen the glance you gave him today when he giggled when you thought the only lions were in Africa. Because you hadn't thought of a mountain lion before.
He gets John his Nash. Joy out of it.
He's John Nash mental.
Yeah, Nash your fucking teeth. You know, I'm a big believer in a book called Conversations with God. And Fez has given himself two stents from his bad attitude. So I want you to bring that in and give it to me, Fez, so I can read it.
Oh, well, it's an audio book.
Oh, God. Why can't I read it myself?
If you got 24 hours to listen.
Is it a grandpa? What, is that how much of it is?
Yeah, it said 24 hours of audio.
Damn.
Well, how big is the book?
That shows that you're mental. That you can, rather than read a book, that you need some grandfather figure to read to. Who's reading it? Is it a celebrity?
I think it's the author, whose name I can't remember, and then it's Ed Asner and some woman. They tag in and out as the voice of God.
You know what? Let's even forget the thing. You're going to the mental institution.
No!
Let's even forget the football game.
Yes! Rutgers wins.
No, they don't.
That's what Mr. Bankton just said.
I didn't say Rutgers win. I just said nothing matters.
Mm.
I can't imagine either one of these teams winning. I don't know if there's a way to both teams to lose, and I'm not talking about a tie. I'm talking about they decide after looking at both programs that they both deserve a loss.
I don't think that's possible.
24-17, Scarlet Knights.
That close.
Guarantee.
Huh? What's your pick?
28-24, USF.
So you don't want the points?
No, I don't want the points. I'm just going to take it straight up. Scarlet Knights, 24-17.
Would you give Fez points?
Yeah, I'll give Fez points.
Fez, you want points?
I'll take points.
See, that means you don't believe. Why
is he coming up to offer them?
But if you're guaranteeing something, it means that, and you go, oh, I'll take points, that you really don't believe this team is any good. And I'm going to put that down for the mental health.
Don't write that down.
Here's voices. That's one of the things.
I don't hear voices. It's Fez? An audio book.
Fez?
Yes?
Thank you. Here's voices.
I hear real voices.
I'm not putting in the real.
You have to.
Why adjectives? Frivolous.
Do you ever worry that things are that things are going to happen to you?
Yeah. Ow! I just got hit with a big cup of pens.
Okay. Feels like the sky is falling.
No, I'm afraid of when things are physically thrown at me.
Yeah. All right. So you guys want to have a bet? Hair versus hair is out for me. My bet is this: if you want to do it on the air, you have to check into a mental institution over the weekend. And for Dave's big fear, that means buried alive, as they do in that institution. Are you just saying you're so claustrophobic that you'll feel like you're buried alive
in there? Exactly. That's the way I'll feel. Like, it's like that scene from Kill Bill. I'll just, you know, I would feel just the pressure of being in there, and that I think it would be nearly unbearable. I would fucking flip out worse, I think, if that ever happened to me.
What do you fear about it, Fez? Is the claustrophobia also?
Yeah, because with me, it's the lock of the door on the room where I can't get out. It's the thought of maybe a straitjacket or...
Why can't you think of that as a nice blanket?
Because I could get out from under a blanket. A straitjacket I can't get out of. I'm not Houdini.
Maybe you wouldn't want to. Maybe you'll be so comfortable in that straitjacket.
Or just the not being able to move your arms if you're, like, shackled to the bed or something. And not
now
being
you're
able
an S&M fucking bitch. They don't shackle you to a bed.
Like Sarah Connor in Terminator 2.
If you say these fears to any mental health professional, they're going to lock you up. It's like Sarah Connor. Don't Sarah Connor me.
It's totally claustrophobic.
You are fucking bananas. Bananas. Out of your mind. Johnny, which one of them would you rather see locked up?
Probably Dave.
You think Dave belongs to be locked up?
Because Dave has to check his levels sometimes. Sometimes he's overly too crazy.
Yeah, I know. You're right.
Shit out of me.
That is a great thing.
Sometimes he scares the shit out of me.
You need to check your levels. Where Fez is pretty consistently agitated or depressed. You have a way of blowing up like fireworks, but in the back of the truck. You know what I mean? Like when the fireworks guy is heading there and it just explodes. Everyone likes fireworks, yeah. But not for them to explode in the car that you're in. And that's what you do.
I don't see that at all.
Thank you, Bronx Johnny. High Society, it's going to be on this Saturday at midnight on XM202 The Virus.
Should be fun.
Earl, you hear both of them are claustrophobic. Maybe we do a... all right, I'll tell you what we'll do. We'll do a WWE kind of style. Buried Alive match.
What does that mean? What does that mean? What does that mean?
Like, remember the Undertaker used to be in those matches? You had to go in a coffin and they throw dirt on it.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Fuck
me. What is it, a coffin match?
Yeah.
So there's a coffin match and what you said, the Buried Alive match.
Now, which is which?
The coffin match, you just have to throw your opponent in a casket to win close the lid.
Why don't other sports do stuff like that? Eventually, you have to be able to throw Tom Brady in a casket, shut the lid, and then your team wins the Super Bowl.
It's like a really extreme safety.
Yeah.
So Buried Alive, yeah, you do get buried alive in the WWE matches.
All right, we could do this. I mean, obviously, if we want to do it in studio, we can't do that. But we could bring a coffin in here. You're placed in the coffin for the show. Let's say... 2.5 hours.
Oh, jeez.
Spent in a coffin. So we'll bring the coffin in, and that person has to get in there, and we can put a mic in. Now, do we have to worry about air, Earl? Like, Earl knows any of this.
Any bed where you say, do we have to worry about air? It's maybe a bad thing.
But, I mean, we don't have dirt. We can't bury alive. But we could duct tape a coffin.
Oh, man. That's horrifying.
So we could duct tape a coffin. Now, Earl, do you know how much? Because I know they put those guys in coffins in those things, so you got some amount of air. But do you have 2.5 hours? Why are you holding on, Fezzy?
Because I'm thinking about going in the casket. In the casket match.
Horrible. Horrible. I'm almost getting claustrophobic in this spacious studio right now.
Can I tell you something?
Yes.
I feel claustrophobic even having the idea. Because I plan on being burnt up so I don't have to go in a coffin. Because even at dead, a coffin would drive me crazy.
Oh, my God. I've never lied even still. Like, I'm a tosser and turner when I go to sleep. Oh.
What would you rather do, the coffin or a mental health facility for a weekend? Think it over. You don't have to decide right now.
Okay.
But it's a short 2.5 hour stint in a duct tape coffin.
Yeah.
Or 2 days plus, it's kind of open-ended with you guys, in a mental health facility. Because we could get you in for 2 days, but once you started freaking out and scratching at the walls, they may keep you. They might have to do that for public safety. Earl, what would you rather do?
Yeah, me personally, I would... oh, my God. The coffin thing is...
What would you do, Earl?
I would go in the coffin.
Over a weekend in a mental health facility? A place that has group therapy and one-on-one therapy?
Plus, you have the usage of a bathroom and food. Like,
yes,
you kind of deprive
at a TV.
Yeah.
You're in there, you're meeting people, you're doing group, you're going... And then you're saying like this... You know what, doctor? I didn't even realize that. I'm going to start look at life differently. I don't have to fear things.
This is impossible because I understand the bathroom and probably you get like beverages at the mental institution. So that's a good thing. But if I was in the coffin, at least I'm surrounded by you guys.
How do you know? We've duct taped it shut.
Oh, God. I hate that part of it.
So even if you want to get out, it's going to take us... You know what it's like to pull duct tape off anything.
Oh, sure.
That's a fucking problem. So if you're like, I'm freaking out. I got to get out right now. Even if we wanted to, all we could do is take an axe and smash the coffin to try to get you some kind of air.
Oh my God.
If we couldn't get a coffin, being it like the best, could we do like a Croatian coffin where we just get a big fridge?
I didn't know they do that down there. Lock them in a fridge?
They bury some people in the fridge, like when, I think it was where they had that massacre with Serbia.
Because they ran out of coffins?
Yeah, they just started using fridges.
Would you guys rather be locked in a fridge? Duct taped into a fridge?
I remember those PSAs from when I was a kid.
I remember my uncle had to throw the fridge out, right? So he had to spend all day trying to rip the door off, and he was so fucking furious. Because you just can't throw a, you know, put a refrigerator outside anymore because so many kids have crawled in them and died. Yeah. So he's out there trying to fucking take the fridge door off, and it was taking him all day. Finally, he just took a pickaxe and destroyed.
My and dad glued the door when we had to throw away our fridge.
With a kid inside? Yeah, a lot of kids have died that way. That's why I worry about you guys getting in a coffin.
This is horrible, man. I mean, I want to do one of them, but like, I don't want
to. I would recommend mental health. I'll leave it up to the listeners. All right. 866-RON-0-FEZ. 866-RON-0-FEZ. Here's the bet, and it would take place tonight, so I'd like to get the coffin in here tomorrow, because neither one of you is trustable. Neither one of you pay off a fucking bet.
Okay.
Should they spend the weekend with a nice mental health getaway? By the way, it does go on your permanent record.
Oh,
or B, duct tape coffin. And we tried to put that on Pal Talk. Please. I'm sure we could use the O&A account, right? And just,
yeah, we could do that.
Put a coffin over there.
That part would be easy.
Coffin's horrifying. I am fucking...
Not after what this fucking prick said.
What?
But I'd be like, fuck those guys. They're not using our cameras. All right, I will check with the listeners. Would you rather hear duct tape coffin, which I got news for you. I don't know if I can stay in here because I'm a little freaked out from even saying it. Or mental health weekend. Jeremy, duct tape coffin or mental health?
Well, if you went in the duct tape coffin, you would die after about 50 minutes. You'd pass out in about 2 hours, you'd be dead.
All right, so that's rough because we need him in there for 2.5 hours.
Cutting it close.
Dan, duct tape coffin or no?
Coffin. It's only, you're in the studio anyway. A weekend, you're gone for the weekend.
JW, coffin or mental health?
I would say coffin there, boss, because of the fact that I work for a casket company, and they're going to run out of air in about 15 minutes.
All right, so that's going to be tough. Matt, coffin or weekend?
Coffin, Ronnie.
All right.
Oh, Jesus.
Hi, Ron and Fez Show. What do you got for us? Hi, you're on the Ron and Fez Show.
Yeah, is it me?
Yeah, what do you got?
I think they should do the coffin. It'll be more entertaining on the air.
All right, coffin it is. Steve, coffin or no?
Hello?
Yeah.
Yeah, man, you put Dave in the mental institution, and I'm not going to even try to do it, Ronnie, because you do it better than him. Anybody, he's going to be asking for his own cigarettes. So, the coffin.
Coffin, there we go.
Oh, my God.
Mark, you're on Run of Fez.
Yeah, I got to go coffin, Ronnie.
Rich, you're on Run of Fez.
Hey, buddies. I'd say definitely the mental institution. Mythbusters did a piece on the guys laying in a coffin. They needed an oxygen supply, and both of them freaked out after about 45 minutes.
All right, so we might need an oxygen supply. I didn't even see this Mythbusters.
No, me neither.
I didn't see it myself, although I do love that show, but this is starting to get a little scary here.
It is scary. Joe, you're on Run of Fez.
Yeah, I say a casket. If you need one, I'll bring you one tomorrow. You can get a non-sealer casket, air gets in, so you don't have to worry about air not getting in. It's called a non-sealer casket.
All right. Earl, write that down. We need a non-sealant casket. Very important, because we want them to experience pain. We don't want them to die. Dying's bad. Jeff, you're on Run of Fez.
I know he'll get that backwards.
Definitely mental health, because then they've got a whole weekend to freak out instead of 15 minutes of suffocation.
All right, here's Sean. Sean, what do you got?
Hissing cockroaches in the coffin.
Coffin. Jim, what do you got?
Coffin. I got to hear this.
All right, Fezzy, where's the score right now?
All right, it's 10-2 in favor of coffin over mental health.
Yeah, let's just call this. This is fucking ridiculous.
I thought with health and then mental name, it might come off better to the listeners.
I would keep this going, but I got a guy on the phones right now that can't keep up with it. We got to train somebody for those phones, Fezzy. I hate to say it, but as an executive producer, you belong in a coffin. And then that coffin should be put in the ground, sealed with cement, and then left.
That's just burying me alive for good.
So this is going to be great. Loser goes into a coffin.
Great.
And
oh my
I like
gosh.
It. Why are you shaking?
Because I could lose and go into a coffin.
Well, just say South Florida Blows. University of South Florida Blows and so does Tampa Bay area.
No, I'm not going to say that.
Earl, Dave, just say Jersey sucks.
I can't do that. Let's go Rutgers if you ever needed to win a game. Please.
You know what? Here's what I love.
Please.
This is another chance for you two lazy bastards to take off Friday. It's just a chance for you to lay down and let the show happen around you.
I don't see it that way.
I see it, both of you as getting shelter.
It's in a tiny, tiny coffin.
I'll tell you something else. There's a storm threatening your very life today. And if you don't get some shelter, you're going to fade away. I'll tell you, children, it's just a shot away. It's just a shot away. That's what you're after right now.
Oh, no. Don't play this song either.
This is the song we'll play as you're going in. Because you're getting shelter.
It won't be piped in, will it?
This is... I've told you that one time where I had to get my knee done, and I was putting one of those tubes.
Yeah.
And it was the worst experience of my life.
Well, now it's going to feel cozy.
It's not going to feel cozy.
You're
going to
be dry. You're going to be comfortable. You're surrounded by claustrophobic pillows.
Is the coffin going to be on some sort of gurney or something with wheels where you can spin them around every once in a while?
Please.
No, I wouldn't even mind putting this underground.
You can't do that.
We'll just lower you in. Now you know what it's like to be at your own funeral.
Rutgers, please.
I don't know if nice things will be said.
Do you see him?
No.
No, I'm not going to plug.
Please, Rucker.
This is you as you're getting lowered in.
Please, please, please.
We're going to turn this into a pagan funeral. Light that sumbitch on fire. It's only 2 points. Basically a toss-up.
Need this victory. Really need it.
The Bulls keep the winning streak alive.
This is the only reason for me now to watch this game tonight. Which I probably still won't. I'll just check online to see who's gone in the coffin. Earl, I want a coffin in here tomorrow.
We will have a coffin in here tomorrow.
I like the attitude. I might have you on my eye on you as a new executive producer.
Thank you.
If God forbid Fez dies in that coffin.
Yes, God forbid. And remember the non-sealant part.
If Fez has to go on the coffin, I want to sit on the coffin.
This might be a reason to bring people into the studio tomorrow. Let them sit in the bleachers and watch someone in the coffin.
It's a great idea.
Earl, is your girlfriend coming in? Pops?
I'd love to meet Pops. Oh, meat pops. That sound good.
Give me shelter. It's all coming down. Loser goes into a coffin for Friday's show.
Please, Rutgers.
And it's got to be a non-sealant coffin. Hey, can we put a phone in there or a mic in there with them? Try to find that out from the people. Because I don't think a lot of people go, oh, and we need phone service in that coffin. Rape. Murder, it's just a shot away. It's just a shot away. This might be as good as rock and roll gets. And I hate saying that to you, Earl. I know you're Soulja Boy, and you feel like that's the fun. You feel like that's the future. So, Fezzi, we don't know what to do. With the conversations with God don't work. The pills don't work.
No. And I think that's one thing that really got me angry again.
Mm-hmm.
You know, talking to the therapist yesterday. That none of the pills work. And I'm stupid enough to try them every time. Because I get to a desperate place where I feel like, what else do I do but try to take a pill? You know, and I feel stupid for trying it again. That gets me pissed off.
Did you strangle your cat?
No, I haven't strangled the cat yet.
That might help. When that cat's dead, you'll be free.
I'm not a big fan of the cat.
Well,
I'm really like, wow. I said to her the other night. I go, I don't like you.
Surprise! He doesn't like pussy.
Ouch. You know what? The low-hanging fruit, we don't even grab it on this show. Of course the pussy joke's there. You got a guy here with a mohawk. He's angry at God. He hates his cat. He's not happy. You're not a happy guy.
He waddles when he walks.
All right, so what's next for you, Watley? What are you going to do about this?
I don't know. I mean, I go back to the therapist next Wednesday. I go see the shrink on Tuesday. I honestly don't know, and that's what I was...
They need to be fired.
That's what I was telling her yesterday. I go, I don't know. I don't know what I'm going to do.
You think there's another therapist for you out there? Because these two don't know their ass from a hole in the ground. They don't know what the fuck they're doing.
I don't think they have enough life experiences for you.
They've never seen anything like Watley come through the door. I'm telling you right now, I don't think Freud could handle him. If we brought zombie Freud back from the dead, I think he would just go, I cannot help you.
Would you try a church therapist, though?
A what?
Like a church therapist where you go, like the religious one?
They'll try to drown him in holy water. He doesn't. He is worse than an atheist. He believes in an evil God. He thinks that God is like a 12-year-old boy, giant God boy, trying to burn us with matches. That's what he thinks of God. Maybe it'd be better for a different religion and get away from Christianity.
Yeah, I mean, that could be. I mean...
The Scientology works for so many talented people.
Buddhist Fez.
The spirituality thing, I just don't feel it, though. I mean, no matter what the religion is.
Yeah.
I'm not feeling that.
All right, you don't like the mental. You hate working out. You hate the physical. And you hate the spiritual. There's only three realms that we have, Fez. You have turned your back on every one of them.
I need a fourth realm.
Dental. Let's try anything.
Why bring that up when you know he's upset? Look how mad he is.
Kill him.
Don't.
Kill him.
Fez, your teeth are fine. Don't let him keep doing that. He's fucking with you.
I know. The rat smile was talking about my teeth.
Just because of the bet, the Rutgers USF, I'm getting competitive.
I'm worried that if you get in that coffin, whatever it is from the other side is going to come and grab you. I'm fucking terrified.
If you open it and I'm not in it,
I am terrified that you're a goner.
I won't be in the casket tomorrow. It'll be Side Dave.
No.
Kane Undertaker? What's the
one? I'll tell you the truth. I don't care either way. One of you fuckers is off the show tomorrow. That's a fantastic Friday for me. I don't know where to begin with you, Fez. Like you said, you've got work to do mentally, physically, and spiritually. That's a tall fucking thing. I can't imagine that you could do that on a day thing. You're going to have to go away probably for 6 months.
6 months?
Yeah.
And you probably should be handcuffed when you go away, too. And handcuffed quite extensively.
Why? And what how do you get handcuffed more extensively than just handcuffed?
We can't answer him back, Fuzzy. Do me a favor. And this is the showing of your insanity. Asking this motherfucker a question and expecting an answer. I'll tell you, everything in your life is so bad. Your telephone, I don't know whether you've ever called Fez at home before, so his telephone will tell you he's not home, call back and leave a message.
What?
His message machine tells you to call back and leave a message. And I'm like, fuck you. Why would I call back when the same machine is going to tell me to call back and leave a message?
I don't know why that happens.
It's
and it's not the message machine. It's like whatever set up with the phone company.
Fez, right now you've got Pops is terrified about you being in a coffin.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, and saying that she cannot watch or listen tomorrow if you lose this.
She has to.
I worry about it.
Is that part of the bet?
No, but I'm claustrophobic. I'm not going to lie about it. And if Fez goes into that coffin, I know I'm going to be freaking the fuck out.
Well, first of all, with the Bulls winning, no one's going to have to worry about it. Secondly,
they're not going to win.
Do me a favor. Name three players on the Bulls. So you're betting on somebody you don't even know. Have these guys ever even had a national game yet?
No.
I've never seen him on TV.
They played West Virginia the other week.
Yeah. West Virginia. Like, I'm going to watch a West Virginia game.
Yeah, they played Auburn, too.
Auburn was national.
Saturday night, ESPN.
Hey, it's our buddy J-Dubs. Hello, Dubs.
How's it going, brother?
Hey, man.
Yeah, does Fez get any pleasure out of the Buccaneers anymore or anything?
Do you still like the Bucs?
Yeah, I still like the Bucs. I get pleasure there.
Do you go to those games still?
No, I don't go to them.
Well, this weekend, Bucs versus Lions. Last time I was the ass-to-ass bet. Now I have the Buccaneers logo on my ass. What are we going to do this year?
Oh, I didn't even think of that, Fez.
Yeah, I got a coffin bet tonight.
Double coffin? Double coffin? Monday coffin?
Monday coffin? I guess if we can keep a coffin in here.
Why couldn't we keep a coffin? It'll be in here Friday. We'll leave it here Monday. Would you be willing to get a coffin, Dubs?
Yeah, I'll get a coffin.
Of course you will. What do you care?
Hey, he's practically in one now.
I got emails about... Oh, man. Yeah. See? Your comedy comes from a mean place. Oh. That's a mean place. All right, so, Fez, keep the coffin match going?
Yeah, keep the coffin.
All right, double down.
So I have to dodge two coffins in the next
this
couple days.
Now remember, it's going to have masking tape. We will duct tape the coffin
to make sure it's shut,
and then lower it underground.
That's the part that
I don't like. That.
Me.
Two things happen when I was a kid. One, we're playing baseball in the street. Ball goes into a sewer, right? So my buddy goes down in the sewer to get it. Here comes, and this is the worst word that you could hear when you're a little kid. The teenagers. Teenagers, to me. Earl, I'd rather seen 20 black guys my own age than one teenager when I was a kid. I don't know what it is. If you're like 7, 8 years old, a teenager, it must have it's like saying Cossack. Like they would just run in and burn and rape and drag things off. Frightening. So he's down. He's getting the wiffle ball out of the fucking sewer. Here comes the teenagers. They push the fucking manhole cover over top of him and stand on it. Oh. As I can hear his muffled screams and scratching at the manhole. The fucking kid standing on top of it, to me, looks huge. He's probably 13 or 14. He's got a hideous witch laugh. Like, he is almost coming. He's so excited knowing that he's fucking killing this thing. Then another one of our friends, we were all buddies, but we all had older brothers who were, I hate to use the T word again, teenagers. They fucking wrapped him up in a carpet, and he's fucking stuck in a carpet. His fucking arms and legs can't move, and he's screaming that he's suffocating and dying. As they laugh hysterically. And I honestly think that those two instances have left me scarred. I honestly think that I hate the thought of, I always like to know that I can leave any situation.
Right, yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, I don't care what I'm doing. I can do anything. But I like to know, yes, I know this can go on forever, but I'll leave whenever I want to. I don't like any situation that I don't know where it, you know, or how it ends.
This is terrifying.
So you guys in a coffin. And again, what happens if you're in that coffin, it's duct taped, and a 9/11 situation happens?
Oh,
we're not going to be able to get you out of there. We're going to run for our own safety.
I mean, we're living like 15 people here.
We live in an age of terrorism. If something fucking happens to this building, everybody will forget you.
Let's have designated pallbearers to get that casket out of here.
You know what? You can hope for it, but you are, and this is my thing, you are not in control of your own destiny.
All right.
And that's the way I hate to be. I know people can say, don't worry, bro, I'll let you out. How do you fucking know? How do you know they can? How do you know a fire won't happen in this fucking building? We're not going to have the time to cut you out. You're going to be trapped and burnt. It can happen.
Let's just get a pair of scissors.
I don't have scissors that can cut through duct tape.
It's going to scissor can't cut through duct tape.
We're going to put so much duct tape that it's going to probably take 20 to 30 minutes to get you out.
Oh, yeah.
We're going to duct tape it tight.
At least.
All right. Cremated and buried in the coffin.
Hey, you're already there.
So, I mean, this is a scary thing. And Dubs, you want to do this. You want to double coffin down.
Yeah, I'll do the coffin. I have a whole death fear lately anyway, but that should make it even more interesting.
You're afraid of death? You're afraid of dying?
I feel like I'm close to it. So it does feel like, I'm more afraid of it than ever right now.
Mm. Well, it's not so much being dead, but the thing of knowing I'm dying. And we're each going to know that feeling. We're each going to know when our soul goes slipping out of our bodies, whether it's from being suffocated in a coffin or dying in a fiery crash of a 9/11 type disaster that takes place while you're in the coffin. So we're all going to know. And it might be like good therapy to just kind of close your eyes and meditate for a moment of that pure terror of when your soul leaves your body.
I don't think that's helpful.
I mean, we're going to die. Everybody's going to die.
I know. I hate that about us.
Yeah, and you die alone. No matter how much friends and loved ones you have in your life, that is the lonely journey. That is that trip across the river with just you and death together. Just the two of you.
Don't want to die tomorrow.
You and the journeyman.
No.
You and the ferryman. Don't pay the ferryman until you reach the other side. You could die tomorrow if Rutgers lets you down.
Rutgers, you fucking have got to win this football game. Yeah.
But do you know, like, I mean, you will start hallucinating in that coffin because you don't have the sensations of what you have out here anymore.
Oh, yeah.
So you will hallucinate, and all your terrors will dive into you. And those are the terrors that speed up your heart, your breathing. And as you breathe too much, where's that oxygen going to come from? You're in a locked coffin. You got no. Yeah. You got nowhere.
Just recycling.
Oh, my God. I'm panicking
and
right now.
And God forbid a fire happens or a 9/11 situation.
All right.
And the rest of us are forced to run out.
Yeah. We have got to figure out a solution to that.
No matter what you figure out, you're depending upon other people.
Yeah, I do have to wear something loose fitting.
Yeah.
Either that or wear a suit just to see what the real one will be like.
Honestly, I don't think I'm going to wear clothing. If I have to do it, I'm just going to wear my boxers, I think.
All right, Casey has another idea.
The mortician out.
Rather than duct tape, and she's always thinking about Dave, she would like to hammer and nail this thing.
What? That's worse than duct tape. That's
Houdini time.
Then that's 9-inch nails. That's 9-inch nails.
No!
No! Dubs, what made you start to fear death?
Well, it's like going out on bottom. I don't want to go out, you know, this low, sleeping in a bed with no sheets for my dog. You know?
When's the last time you were on the air? When was the last time you had a steady gig?
Steady gig was last November.
All right, so I've known guys being on the beach before, but a year, I've never even heard of that. I've never heard of anyone being out for a year. And you guys, I remember when you called and said this, I said, don't worry. I know Bob Eatman. He likes to keep his guys working. He's going to have your job. And my wildest dreams, I didn't think we'd be sitting here 11 months later. I mean, to me, that's worse than death.
Yeah, I would agree. I would definitely agree with that right now. Working in a restaurant, you know, trying to make bills and having no sheets for my bed, it's not fun.
Yeah, you ought to ask us to bury you.
He's getting it free.
The coffin will have sheets.
Boy, your comedy comes from a mean place, Fez. Just an awful, terrible, mean place. Earl, give me a little something for the edge, would you? All this talk about suffocation. But although suffocation is probably not that bad because your lungs fill up with your own fluids.
What?
So you drown?
Yeah. Yeah, you basically drowned in your own fluids.
Oh, my God.
Doesn't sound like a good way to go.
No, it's awful.
Sounds like a fun bet.
Because I don't even know if the hallucinations are, you know, it's like they can't be good hallucinations.
No, they'll be
on your way out.
They'll be terror.
Yeah, so you're not even going to get that piece of being out of your mind.
Just in case some shit pops off, though, shouldn't the person in the coffin wear like a diaper or something? Just in case we forget the coffin's even here.
You know what? That's a good idea. You guys want to put a diaper on?
Yeah, I think that's a good idea, too.
If you
already got one.
You should be wearing a diaper all the time. Yeah, there we go.
Are you really wearing an adult diaper today?
Yeah.
How come?
It depends. No.
I just don't think you are.
Well, I was just... everything was a little loose this morning.
Oh. What?
Yeah. Shit? Yeah.
What was loose?
Yeah. You're an asshole.
I'm just going to yell out Sierra Mist when I don't understand the joke. I'm just going to say it's Sierra Mist. All right. Earl, that coffin we were going to rent, just buy it outright because it seems like we're going to have a lot of events here. All right, talk to you later, Dubs.
Later, bro.
God, I love that kid. I can't believe the troubles he's had. I can't believe the troubles. All right, we got to get going, guys. Thanks for coming in. Thanks for bringing the food. Fred, always
no
a pleasure
problem.
To see you. Also, I want to tell Dave's girlfriend that, you know, she's a great mother. to him.
Thank
See you.
You
guys tomorrow for the Coffin Day. Big game tonight. Homestar, what is it?
That's the end of my show. Donk.
Fezzy, I didn't have a chance to watch the game last night. Who won?
Rutgers won. They stopped South Florida's winning streak.
There is a coffin sitting in the studio today. Mm-hmm. An actual coffin. This came from, I think Pitsy knows somebody in the business, as we said, Fezzy. To prove, this is something we never do. We never turn on the Pal Talk cameras.
Oh, true. Yeah.
We like to look. We don't like people to watch. But today we've turned it up. And a gorgeous kind of red maroon coffin is sitting in here. Now, here's how you get to see this. You go to Pal Talk, to the Ron and Fez showroom, and the it's under On the Pits. So this is Pitsy's account. But Fez, you will be climbing into a coffin and staying there for hours.
First of all, I don't want to go in the coffin.
Mm-hmm.
Secondly, this is a crew that can't get drinks when we have food.
That is fucking true.
And yet a coffin gets delivered here in a day's time?
Not even a day. Pitsy had that thing in hours. Some kind of Long Island Undertaker. Now, here's the bad thing. And Mikey Boy, you're here, and everybody knows Mikey Boy is totally honest. It's an actual coffin.
Yes, it is.
Does it stink from formaldehyde?
It smells awful. Yeah.
Yeah. Now, I had a buddy growing up, Eddie Ward. His parents were in the undertaking business, and that's what he does now. So I've been around this stuff before. I know the stench of formaldehyde. This is a fucking used coffin. It must have been a coffin that they used for viewings. Then you take it out. There's also a stained pillow, which, first of all, if it's my grandmother, I want a brand new pillow, bitch. I'm not in there. I'm trying to save money, obviously.
Sure.
But I do not want an old pillow.
Yeah, so that's someone's formaldehyde that has leaked out of their neck.
Yeah.
While they were in there. And that thing just reeks. I couldn't believe the smell of it.
I got news for you. I'd rather lay down on a jizz pillow. I'd rather lay on a jizz pillow than a formaldehyde pillow.
It'd be softer.
Bill, you're on Ron and Fez.
29875, my brother.
Hey, buddy.
Hoo-ah!
Ronnie, please lock the opening song, In the Coffin with Fez. Enough already.
All right, here's Ivan. Ivan, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, Ronnie, I was, at first I didn't like Fez's openings, but if I listen to him for another week or two, I think I'll be ready to take it up the ass.
Just even having that thought means you're ready to take it up the ass. Anytime you say, I think I'm ready, you're ready! Mike, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Ronnie, if Fezzy picked that, Sean, nail him in the fucking coffin, buddy.
Yeah. You know what I'd be willing to do here, Fez?
What's that?
If you give up the music, I know you're executive producer.
Yeah, I'm the EP, and I love doing the music every morning.
By the way, you're the first person who appreciated the emotion I've ever met in my life. But if you give up the music and give it back to Pepperhead, I'll let him hop in the coffin for a half an hour.
All right.
Kind of a tag team. Pepper?
Huh. Oh, hell fucking no.
What? No, no,
no. Not in that fucking box.
You get the music back.
You can keep the gay shit. I am not getting that fucking coffin.
I got news for you. There are several people here. Now, me, I am claustrophobic, Fez. And I don't know what sane person wouldn't be claustrophobic. I want the use of my arms and legs. I want my own freedom. That's what America's based on, having freedom. I like mine all the time.
Sure.
But, so, I am a little freaked out that you're getting in there, and I got news for you. I was, and I hate to say this, cheering for the Bulls last night. I thought that they were going to pull it out, even when there was only 2 minutes left, because I figure East Side Dave could get in that coffin. He's a little thinner. Slightly thinner.
I don't think that has much to do with it.
He has a stronger heart. Let him get in the coffin. So, I'm nervous about that. But I'm only nervous because you're claustrophobic.
Yeah.
There are people on our staff that are freaked out just because it's a coffin. They honestly feel like the coffin is devil's work.
Oh, yeah, it's a doorway to the afterlife.
And, Earl, you won't even come in here so far.
No, I'm not going to even... I'm shaking right now. I'm scared
Earl,
of that.
Earl, would you take a half hour for your man, Fez?
No.
Take
no
a half
way.
Hour.
I am not getting in that coffin.
Come on, Earl.
No. I'm not getting in that coffin.
And yours is based on what? You think that you'll fall there into the underworld?
I just freaking out. I I don't want to get in there when I'm dead. I'm not getting near that coffin.
I know. I have the same thing. I don't want to be in a coffin when I'm dead either. That's the whole thing. I want to be cremated. I mean, who wants to be burned up? I just don't want to know that my body is stuck in a box. It freaks me out. My throat's starting to close up right now. It might even be from the formaldehyde stink.
I know. There's so few options once you go. It's the box or the fire, or you end up in one of those bodies exhibits where they put you on display from a taxidermist.
All right. I have the Pal Talk room up, Fezzy, and it's blowing up so people can watch. Now, Dave, you know about this. You don't have to sign up to come in and watch, do you?
No, you can just go right to Pal Talk, go right to the Ron and Fez room. And
I thought it was Ron and Fez showroom.
Ron and Fez showroom, and then find I Am the Pits.
And when you do that, you see, all right, that's the picture that we have up on our computer.
Yeah.
That looks scary, and it looks scary as hell as a picture.
It's very frightening, very ominous.
Yeah. All right.
Oh, I do not want to get in that thing.
Now, who's in charge of that Pal Talk room? Is that HTG?
That's, HTG created that room.
Well, she actually wrote in there, good, Fez, get in the fucking box.
Why would she write that?
I don't know. And she's eating an apple, which I find to be just totally against everything we're trying to do here.
I know, it's really inappropriate to sit there and snack while someone else is getting in a box.
Remember, I told you I had that problem when people yelled at me at my uncle's funeral for eating a Butterfinger.
Yeah. It's inappropriate.
You know what? In hindsight, I should have eaten it in the back. I'm standing over top of it. I had it in my jacket. And I ate a Butterfinger. I worry about my blood sugar. Or just sugar. You're a monster! What? I'm here. I'm wearing a clip-on. I just wanted a Butterfinger.
Getting crumbs on the body.
Earl, you won't do it.
Come on, Earl.
No way.
A half hour.
No way I'm
going. Earl, you get in for 5 minutes. I'll take a half hour off Fez.
No. That's 5 minutes too long.
Earl, you won't even do that much?
No. Here's nothing. What zero.
I hate you.
Here's what I like. People that... now, also, I'm showing you have no friends.
Oh, obviously,
which
yeah.
Which I've tried to point out to everybody. I told Mikey background this, too. When trouble is in your life, that's when you have no friends.
Mm-hmm.
You have friends when you're the easygoing, everything's going your way, you're buying drinks for the room. Boy, do you have a lot of buddies. When you're in trouble, no friends.
Yeah, and you brought this up yesterday, how you die alone. I'm obviously dying alone. There's not one person that would take 5 minutes for me.
But you got those big mutton chops and that stupid haircut.
Yeah, I hope the mohawk doesn't add too much height to me so I can't get in it. That would be a shame.
Ugh. Dave, were you freaking? By the way, it was the worst game ever. Two terrible teams playing a terrible game.
It was a little sloppy. But
it was Big East.
I was, believe it or not, I was quite excited at first when Rutgers won because I won the bet. I feel like, you know.
Well, it could have went either way.
Yeah.
It was two awful teams doing awful work, an embarrassment to ESPN. And they're using words like slobberknocker and trying to act like it's going good.
Smash mouth. But,
yeah, smash mouth. They can't even hold on to a fucking football. There's no plays. Drop back. USF's quarterback has one play. Drop back, scramble, throw the ball high and far, and somebody will run underneath it. It's not fucking football. It's dodgeball.
And forward lateraling and just weirdness.
Oh, the fake fucking gimmick play. When you're already leading, you know what I mean? You don't do that.
Bush league.
It's all Bush. So it's a hideous game. You had to be shitting yourself.
I was, because we had a nice lead, and then SFU's coming back.
USF.
What's
the difference?
You're going to forget him anyway. So when they got to 30-27, I got extremely nervous. But when Rutgers, hey... Coach Chiano, New Jersey Pride, Scarlet Fever running rampant, and when they closed them out, I was jumping for joy. Then I have to admit, half an hour went by.
Was Casey jumping for joy?
She was jumping for joy.
See, she hates me.
Yeah. I can't stand that Casey roots against you, Fez.
And it's in everything.
Yeah. And she was saying, like, you know.
She hopes I fall on the subway tracks every day.
Well, I don't know if she thinks that, but she was rooting against you.
We were both laughing and chanting, fuck him, fuck him, fuck. And, but I know, can I just be honest for a second? A half an hour or so after the game and after the buzz of being the sports king,
mm-hmm.
I have to be honest, I I really feel a little bit, I feel terrible.
You know what that's like? It's like fucking your buddy's girlfriend, where you're like, this is great, I'm now on her, and then later, you get that twinge thing.
Yeah.
And I looked that up, I Googled it, actually. That's guilt. You can get a little guilt feeling from fucking your buddy's girlfriend and or wife.
Yeah.
One time I did it both. I had a three-way with my buddy's wife and his girlfriend.
And that's the way it felt. Like, we had just fucked Fez, like, really hard, right in the ass, because...
Why didn't I feel good about it, then?
Because...
You couldn't feel his little dick going in that fucking manhole you call an ass. And that literally is a manhole.
Please don't write the thing for my tombstone.
This really will be like a funeral for you.
Oh, I know. If anyone has anything nice to say while I'm in the box, I doubt that'll happen.
Yeah, so about... And then, like, an hour went by, and honestly... Casey was getting a little bit upset, emotional. I was a little bit upset. I mean, not to be a pussy. I was kind of tearing up because Fez is an older man with a bad heart, and you know, he's got so many problems. He's like, you know, borderline insane.
All
to
right,
begin with.
Just stop trying to help him.
You know, if you want to build me up for this, you're going the wrong direction.
Well, no, but honestly, basically, what I'm saying is, I really do feel bad. No shit. I just feel... I feel bad.
Okay. Frenchie wants to know if we can put it on in her room, too.
You can't do...
You can only do one room?
Yeah, you can only do one.
Sorry, French. I don't know how that works.
You're out.
I don't even... She's not out.
Oh.
She's still in, but she could pile in that other room, I guess. I don't know how it works.
Join our room for one day.
Yeah, what are the two rooms not like each other?
They hate each other.
All right. So I didn't know that.
So will Casey come in and do a half hour in this box for me? In the coffin?
She said,
she
fuck that.
She feels bad.
Her quote was, fuck that.
You think we could even shut that coffin on her perfect titties? It couldn't happen.
Okay, no. Well, I am sitting here.
They get mushed.
No, I said the word perfect.
You have a titties about a man's
wife. What should I say? Give me a better word.
Like love bags?
All right. You think we could shut that on her beautiful, perfect love bags?
No, they'd mush.
That was a bad suggestion.
Mush isn't a word, is it?
No.
Mooch is. Mooch is in Frenchie's room.
Is he?
Yeah. So I want him to be able to see. I don't know how it works. Earl, 1 minute in, I take a half hour off this.
Please, Earl.
Not 1 second. I am not getting in that damn box.
I can't believe you won't give me a minute of coffin time.
All right, I'll tell you this. I will take an hour off for one of Fez. You give me 1 minute, but it's face down in the coffin.
Face up, face down, nothing. Nothing. Zero.
You are
in that coffin.
You are
look at
a horrible person.
Look at his eyes. He's got the feet's don't fail me now eyes.
I know. He should be a conductor on a train in a black and white movie.
I don't even know what that means.
Scatman.
Sierra Mist. Sierra Mist.
I'm sorry. I'm going in a coffin.
All right. One of your med buddies is in the room, Fezzy. Nikki's in the room, and she said she's going to be there for you.
Oh, thank you. If she would be in the coffin for me, that would be even nicer.
Give me a half an hour for Fez. That's all I'm asking for.
Nobody will.
Nobody's going to do it. It's going to be disgusting, though. I can't stand the smell. I might even have to leave while you're in there.
I know. It's bad enough, the whole claustrophobic thing, which I have.
Mm-hmm.
But why sit there and stink?
Why did you go and pick this stupid team that I told you stunk? I hate college football now, just for how fake it is. It's as bad as boxing. The way that somehow a team that didn't even exist 3 months ago, they didn't even have a program
right.
3 months ago. Worst helmets in history, worst colors in history. And, Fezzy, I know that you like Tampa.
Yes.
I know that's your hometown. Did you see the article about this trailer park in St. Pete?
No.
There's 200 trailers. 96 of the trailers... are owned by sexual predators. People who have been arrested for sex crimes. A lot of pedophiles, rapists, they all live in the same trailer park together.
That's going to be the wrong neighborhood to wander into trick-or-treating.
No, or for you, that in the first place, young Fez Watley would have went.
I call it Shangri-La.
I just wonder who the other 104 people are. That right. They're living just surrounded. They must feel like an Italian in Chinatown.
And do they have kids?
Yeah, right. Kids, stay in. Stay in the trailer.
I hate on the game last night when they kept showing the USF you know, fans watching the game on the screen.
How
in their
stupid camp. They are.
And how many people were there? About 38? It wasn't like there was like 10,000 people watching the screen in their gymnasium. So every time they would go back, it looked like basically they had the Springer audience. They were trying to make a big deal that they were watching it in an auditorium. It was awful.
All right, so here's how you watch Fez get in the coffin on Pal Talk. And you don't have to sign up. It doesn't cost anybody any money, right, Dave?
Not to my knowledge, no.
Okay. You just go into the Pal Talk room, Ron and Fez showroom. On the pits is the camera. I'm the pits. Well, who would fucking call themselves I'm the pits? You having ego from all you've done so far is get a coffin for Fez. That's all you've done in your life. And a used one. You couldn't get him a new coffin?
Well, I wanted the real experience of him being in there.
Yeah, but, you know, if it was your grandmother, you'd want a new one. Well, maybe you wouldn't, you cheap bastard. How do you know the guy who owns the coffin?
Family friend.
Now, he couldn't have cleaned it up or gotten a new pillow?
I know. Why get the smelly model? The Stink 2007. I told him, I said, I need what you got, baby, and that's what he had. So that's what he brought. That was in their basement, and they brought it over.
Casey says that her husband is the king of sports. The king of sports.
I'd like that to be my nickname.
Yeah. And she also asked the Fez if Dave could sit on top of the coffin like a king. That way you can't.
No!
Well, I don't want you trying to force your way out of there, Fez. So we will masking tape this thing. We're going to duct tape it.
There will be claw marks on the inside of the lid.
My belief is that is the way it is on every coffin. Because I had read before, at a certain point, the soul returns to the body, and you have to try to force your way out.
Where are you reading these things?
So here we go. Fez, this is your chance. This is your chance, your opportunity to do what you've always wanted to do and crawl in a coffin.
I've never wanted to do it. It's never crossed my mind, ever, Ron.
Do you want to take a sandwich in there with you?
No. It stinks and I could choke. That's all I need is a Mama Cass episode inside the casket.
Speaking of which, I'm looking at you and looking at coffee. You might have to go in sideways.
It's not like a waffle iron.
Because your dad called me one time and said that he was putting money down on a piano case.
It's just wrong. And it's so hot in the studio now, I don't know how hot it's going to be inside the coffin.
Obviously, it's going to be hot as hell in there.
Yeah.
If you want, we could hose you down before we put you in.
No, because that's all I need is the mildew smell on top of the formaldehyde.
John, you're on Ron and Fez.
Yeah, Ronnie.
Yeah.
Hey, didn't fucking douchebag Dave give Fezzy points yesterday?
Yeah, 2.5 fucking points. They won by 3. Who's a douchebag now, Johnny?
Give me more.
Give him 4. Just give him 4.
No.
Here's Daniel. Daniel, you're on Ron and Fez.
Yeah, this is Daniel. I'm from California, truck driver. Hey, Earl, you're a pussy. I get in that coffin for Fez. Fez, you sit outside. If I was there, bud, I'd sit in that coffin for you. I'll give a
Earl,
shit.
Earl, get in the goddamn box.
Thank you, Daniel.
Earl, at least come in here. No, come into the room with a coffin.
I don't even want to look at the thing. It's freaking me out.
All right, Dave. I want Dave and Hicks. Grab Earl and force him in here. Bum rush that son of a bitch. Oh, look at him fight back. Look at him fight back.
He hates this stuff.
You're it's going into the coffin.
It's all devil stuff to him.
Come on. Just come into the room. Come on. Right, easy, 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 Dave. Bring him over here to the chair. Earl, just come to the chair. Dave, easy. Easy. You're going to wake up Master Poe. I came in here today, Fezzy. Master Poe was passed out.
Oh, nice.
I could have been carrying a nuke into this place.
Nice
Sit
security.
Down, Earl. Grab a mic.
Jesus.
There's a coffin behind you.
I understand. I'm not even turning around. I'm not even going to look at it.
Just why are you afraid of a box?
I can't even explain. I do not. I'm freaking out right now.
Why are you freaking out?
It's a coffin!
All right, Hicks, do me a favor. Open the lid to the coffin so Earl feels a little more comfortable.
Hicks, don't wear a red shirt next to the coffin. We can't tell which is which.
Hicks is the one with sneakers.
Oh, okay.
Really bad sneakers.
They're both as wide.
All right,
come
yeah,
on.
We got it from the first point.
Do you two guys want to know why we don't hear from Hard Rock Johnny?
Why?
A couple of fucking statements that Watley made. Because you would not drop it. And that's all he's known for. And seriously, he is our friend. And I'm... anyway, I don't want to get in that.
I know, a couple sit-ups.
And I'm very serious now, too. That's why he doesn't hang with us anymore. All right, what are you doing taking pills?
Because I'm like hyperventilating and I'm dry heaving. I am freaking out from this.
Why? What? Tell me what your fear is and I can help you.
It's a box with no with four walls and nothing to look at but darkness. It is freaking me out.
Just think of it as something, a place you go when you die. Is that hideous?
Yeah, it's awful.
Isn't it? That's fucking formaldehyde. That motherfucking Pitsy brought a used coffin in here, and what cheap prick rents a coffin for his grandmother? My family, we buy.
The whole experience must have been cheap because, again, look at the stain on the pillow. The old gal leaked out in there.
I think everybody leaks a little, Fez. I'm not going to
really?
Lie. Really? Yeah. Oh. You can't keep that sealed up because they gut you. They gut you like a fish.
Man.
You didn't know that?
No.
They take everything out, Earl.
Ugh.
They take everything out.
Now, they suck the juices out with a hose.
Yeah, all the blood is taken out, and it's replaced with formaldehyde, and that's what you smell. Now, imagine how that smells for eternity, just stinking from formaldehyde.
Dude, I want a silver cup. I want to be cremated.
I'll do it now. If I can light you on fire, I'll take a half an hour off Fezzy's time.
I'm not getting burned up now.
You'd rather be stuck in a little cup than a box.
Yeah, because
I'm pretty sure you don't stay with the ashes. I think you float around. You actually walk the earth. Oh, what is wrong, Earl? You gonna faint?
Yeah, I'm gonna throw up. It is awful. It's a box. I can't even look at it.
Just take one. Just look at it.
Just try to go over and sit next to it.
I won't even go sit next to it. I really, I can't even put words together right now.
If you're checking it out on Pal Talk right now, it's completely open. The lid is swung open on this thing so you can see the filthy remnants inside.
It's disgusting, isn't it?
Actually, it kind of looks like Easter morning. He has risen.
Good. I'm glad you're making jokes, Watley. Yesterday, you turned your back on God, and what happened to your team? The number two team in the country falls to an unranked team. Why? You won't have conversations with God. That's one of your big problems. Well, you take a nice Catholic boy like East Side Dave.
Thank you, Mr. Bennington.
You don't think God's going to shine down on that?
And like I said I would, I prayed to God, my Savior. I said, I'll give you 50 Hail Marys for a Rutgers 3-point victory or more.
Here's what I love about it. It never occurs to you to pray for Fez.
Never.
You basically had God working against Fez.
Yeah.
Well, you know he's in Dutch with God.
I know, but it was me versus him. Now I feel a little bit bad.
Earl, go over and just kneel next to it.
I won't even kneel.
Next to it and do the rosary. Kneel next to it and do the rosary like your grandmother was in there.
I didn't even do that. Here's the thing. When my grandmother died, I didn't even do that. I didn't go to the funeral. I did nothing. When Muni died, when everyone was doing the kneeling, I did nothing. I did not even go near that casket.
One time we're at a viewing. I think it was... might have been a great-grandfather. So the priest comes in, and all of a sudden, he starts to pray. We all have to hit, right?
Mm-hmm.
We had to kneel, and there's no pews in there. We're in a wake. We have to kneel on the floor. He starts to go through the rosary. And Fez, you ever see the beads?
Uh-huh.
That's Our Father and a Hail Mary for every bead that you see. You hold on to them, and you run through the prayers. I look over at my brother. I go like this. What the fuck? During this thing, I actually had to say the term, what the fuck? It seemed like insane to me. Give us a pew. Something we can do for the knees.
It must have been an hour and a half.
No, it was a while. Finally, I just put a hand down and just fucking, you know, it was basically leaning like, you know, remember in football when they used to hate you for sitting on your helmet? It was that kind of deal. Get off your helmet. We're losing by 20 and you animals are sitting on your helmets. Earl, go next to the coffin.
No, I will not even...
Dave, get him next to the coffin.
Let's go.
No. Come on in here, Hicks. Just get him next to it. Earl, don't fight it. Just go nice to it.
Don't fight this time.
No!
Just get next to the coffin. Easy.
There. Now you're next to the coffin.
No. Just look at it. Look at it.
Please. Earl, just sit. Just sit in the coffin. No.
Please.
The coffin. The goddamn coffin. No.
Get him in.
No.
Get him in.
No.
Get him in.
No.
Earl, just sit in the coffin now.
Get him in.
You're just next to it.
He's gone.
Get him in.
Kneel next to it.
Get him in.
Put him face first into the coffin so he can relax. Face first into the coffin so he... Oh, Jesus! He's being dumped! He's dumped in a box!
Oh, if this was a casket match, it's over.
No, come on, that's over his head there. Look, you got him upside down. You got him upside down. All right, now he's down.
What's wrong with him? The formaldehyde got to him.
The smell got to him.
He's just breathing heavy. Get him some water. He's just breathing heavy.
Now he's freaking. Now we're trying to. Fez, it can't be about you anymore. It's got to be about Earl.
Exactly.
Get him up.
Thanks, Earl. Nice.
Get him some water. Get it on the back of his neck.
He's fine.
Water down the back of his neck.
That was the example I needed going into this. Thank Earl, you for showing me that.
Come
hey,
back
maybe
over
it won't
here.
Be so bad.
What is it, Earl? Get some water on the back of his neck.
Does anyone have any seltzer?
You know, Mikey boy brought an inappropriate amount of seltzer in. What is it, Earl?
I was freaking out.
What?
I couldn't breathe. I was just so...
Well, you can breathe now. Start.
Earl, why do you faint at the worst times? What if someone was trying to put you in a coffin and you fainted? No. No. I want to just put this in context. This city has exploded because somebody put a noose 40 blocks from here, and we're trying to put Earl in a coffin. They're going to come here and burn this studio down. This is not a racial attack. Earl is our friend. We just wanted to lay him in a coffin.
Oh, God.
Earl, you faint so easy. Was it the smell that did it, or just
that
overexcited?
It was all of the above. That odor hits you. It's worse in the coffin.
All right. Can anyone smell Earl? He brought casket smell back over here with him.
Yeah, don't bring your stink smell back over. Was it comfortable, though?
No!
Why? Why do you faint like that, and then everybody fucking gets nervous like it's going to, you know, get in trouble with the bosses?
This had a rush of... I was fighting to breathe.
You are a fucking fainting goat.
It's a coffin!
Earl smells like dead people.
Frenchie keeps texting me. There's no way to get a thing for both rooms.
You can't do
it. I just
it.
Want to make everybody happy.
Just
you know how nice Frenchie is.
For one day. Maybe just for one day.
Will they let her in?
Of course they'll let her in.
Okay. I don't even know what it means. I don't know what it means, Fezzy.
I guess she's out. I don't know.
You're the one out. You're going to be in a coffin because you're a troublemaker. All right. First of all, here was the problem. You had him upside down, and then you were going to smash it on his head. Yeah. Why couldn't you at least throw him in the coffin right side up? Now, do you feel braver, though? Like you could go sit next to it?
No way. I feel worse. Oh, my God.
Earl, if you lay down in an open coffin, I'll take a half hour off Fez.
Please, Earl.
An open coffin.
Nothing.
Please.
Open
no.
coffin.
No. 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 No.
Think about it.
I thought about it. I thought about it. No. No. No, no, no. Oh, my
All
God.
All right, not only that, Earl, you lay in the open coffin for 2 minutes. I take a half hour off Fez, and I don't say I'm fucking... I don't yell at you for an entire month. I don't fucking make any... I don't point out your mistakes for an entire month.
No, I'm not doing it.
That's going to take you almost to Thanksgiving.
But I swear, if you don't do it, lay in an open coffin, open. I will ride you for the next fucking month like you were in boot camp. I'll call you mayonnaise for the next month. And I'll have you doing sit-ups while I squirt you with a hose.
I'll take that chance. I'm not getting back in that box.
It's not a chance.
It's not a chance. He's going to do it.
I do it anyway.
It will be
now
done.
Everybody will just be paying attention.
There's zero risk involved.
Just open.
I'm not going in that box.
Open. Look at me. Look at Fez. You see he's terrified.
Please, Earl.
Oh, look at those hound dog eyes.
All right, I'll put fucking Fez in there right now and fucking tie it off.
Earl, come on, man.
All right,
please.
Take Fez. Take Fez.
No.
And he's going to have to pay now for Earl's sins.
No.
Put him down, face down.
I don't want to. Face down.
Let's go.
Is that what you want, Earl? You want him face down or you want to stand up?
Come on, Earl.
Open coffin. Open coffin.
Not doing it.
Open coffin. Will you do it, Earl?
Not doing it.
Come on, open coffin.
Earl.
Not doing it.
Earl, I don't want to go in it.
Come on, Earl. Earl, open coffin. You please. Please.
No.
Open.
No.
All right, stop.
I'm sorry.
Stop with Fez. What, Earl? Do it.
Earl, please.
No.
Earl, look at me.
What do you want from me?
Open coffin. I'm serious, Earl.
A man's got to honor his obligations.
Oh!
And I'm sorry.
Wait.
I'm not ready.
Earl. Fez can ask you, please, for Christ himself, would you give him a minute to take off a half hour? Open coffin. Not. We won't shut the lid.
Not even a minute. I can't even do a minute. I can't do a second.
For Jesus. For Jesus.
You know what? Jesus didn't even stay in it. He stayed in that coffin for 3 days.
And I'm asking for a minute.
And he bailed.
And I'm asking for a minute.
I can't do it.
Come on.
No.
I know you can roll away the stone.
No.
I know you can do this, Earl.
I can't do it. No.
Earl.
No.
Look at me. No. Look at me, Earl. He will fucking...
Look at him!
He won't do it.
No. Won't do it.
The next month of your life is going to be hell.
I'll live with
Earl,
that.
Earl, no gimmick. What are you doing shaking?
I'm shaking because the thought of getting in that box is freaking
me
out.
Get the fucking box.
It's freaking me out to no end. I'm petrified.
Lay in an open coffin. You have my word, the lid won't come down over your head. 1 minute for Fez.
Earl, please, just 1 minute.
And Earl, for Miles Davis. For the soul of Miles Davis, who we love.
Miles' soul is fine.
You know it isn't. Come on, Earl. Come on, Earl. Be that man. Be a hero. Be a hero. People will love you if you give Fez this. Just give him that opportunity.
1 minute.
Yeah!
Earl
Douglas!
Thank you, Earl!
Earl
Douglas!
60
seconds.
Thank you, Earl.
Second 61.
Then you're out.
Out that box.
Then you're out. There he goes. Lay him down.
Let me take my jacket.
Yeah, take your jacket off. Take his belt, too. I don't want him hanging himself in there. I do not want him hanging himself in there.
I'm not going to hang myself.
Take his shoelaces. Take his shoelaces. Just like he was going into prison.
I'm not gonna give me your shoes. Like,
but Earl, you gotta put your arms over yourself so it looks like you really are dead, so we can get a picture for your parents.
Thank you so much,
there
Earl.
He goes.
Thank
the
you,
big
Earl.
Man. Getting in the box.
Thank you, Earl.
I'm so proud of you, Earl.
Open.
What?
Open.
Well, yes. The top will be open. Go ahead, lay down. He's fucking getting in.
There he goes. You can see it on Pell Talk right now.
There's Earl lying in a coffin like a gentleman. There it is. There he goes. Oh, God. Earl, you barely fit in there. All right, put the bottom down for him so he feels safe.
Just the
Earl, lie back. It's not a kayak.
I understand that, though. You will see a man lose his mind.
Get a double paddle. Get a double paddle. Earl, just put the top up to the side a little bit.
No!
So we know that you know what you feel like.
No!
This is every zombie movie I've ever seen.
All right, Earl, the 60. All right, now, not over his head. Just up so he's comfortable.
All right.
So he knows where he is. All right, Earl. Now, doesn't that feel comfortable? Is that nice?
It doesn't.
Yeah, put the top down just a little bit so he knows.
What the end's going to be like.
All right, Earl, you ready to start your 60 seconds of bliss? What's it smell like in there?
Dead.
You don't want to drop that top, Earl?
No.
Where you can feel comfortable?
He said open.
Now, Fez, when you see him doing that, does that freak you out or make you feel safer?
It totally freaks me out. It really is like he's being entombed. I mean, when the bottom lid over his legs closed,
yeah,
that was frightening enough, just hearing that click.
Now, I swear to God, This is, to me, and I know it's just something in our culture. This would mean nothing if it was just a box.
Right.
But the fact that it's a coffin is the scariest thing. Now, Earl, here's the thing. You're never going to get a coffin this expensive, too. So this is great for you. You want some picture for your folks?
No, this will kill them.
This will kill them.
There'll be three coffins, mine and theirs, when they see these pictures.
This is the way Muni wishes it had worked out.
Oh, jeez. Why bring up Muni at a time like this? All right, put it down just a little bit so you can be comfortable, Earl, in there.
Whoa!
So you can be comfortable and you know you're safe now.
Whoa!
You're beating your fears.
Stop fighting. He's very strong.
Yeah, he is strong.
He's strong for someone in a closet.
All right, another 55 seconds, Earl, is all you got to do.
Oh. You can check out Earl in the casket right now. Pal Talk, the Ron and Fez showroom.
Why is that open?
It's open.
It's plenty open.
Open.
I meant an inch open. That's all. If you turn over, I'll face down.
I'm not.
And then you're gonna
face down. Ass up. Let's go ass up. That's how they bury them in Europe, anyway.
Yeah.
Ass up.
Yeah. Really?
You wanna go European style, Earl?
Well, gay European.
Oh, yeah. Good one.
All right, Fez. You think you can do this now?
No. The more I see Earl in there, the less I think I can go in.
Earl, do you want him to sit on the top of the coffin?
No.
How come you fainted before and now you're able to lay in there? Look how you're beating your fears. This is fantastic.
I'm beating my it's the fear of closure. That's what I'm fearing. Like the threat.
I thought you wanted closure in your life.
I swear this is the best I've ever liked you. It really is. I've never liked you as much as you are right now. Feeling like I could be seeing you for the last second.
That's what I'm afraid of.
Take his rings too, because I don't want him to lose. I don't want to lose those rings.
I have no rings.
Because they'll dig up the grave for those rings.
He's dressed for a coffin.
All right, let him out, and by that I mean push it down hard. No, I'm only kidding. No, let him. All right, let him out. Let him out. All right, he's great. Let him out. Let him out. Let him out of there. Earl, you okay? Come on, you know. Let him out. Did he faint again? No. Earl, get out.
If he wants to stay, fine. It's his choice.
Earl, what part did you like best? Being in the coffin?
Or when the lid hit your noggin?
Zero.
Why, after anger, do you go to fainting? Let him out. Help him out of there.
Come on.
He can't get out of the box.
Come on.
Your undertakers are taking you out.
Look, you got 1 foot in the box now.
All right, if Earl can't do it for a second, how's Fez ever going to do it?
I can't. There is no way I'm going to be able to get in there.
Earl, what are you doing crying? Go cry in front of Pal Talk. Make him cry in front of the Pal Talk camera if you're crying.
Look at the camera.
Go over to the camera.
I'm just trying to get my back.
Look at the camera and cry. Got to bend a little.
Cry in the camera.
Bend down.
Crying.
Bend down. Cry.
Why are you crying? Everybody's on your side. You didn't think we were going to bury you.
He's crying because he got in the casket and then didn't get the parade through Harlem.
All right, so that would have been a jazz parade. You know how we all come back happy?
New Orleans funeral.
New Orleans, though. How did it feel in there? Did it feel comfortable?
Dark, dank, and cold, and it felt like death. I do not want to get buried.
Sounds like his apartment.
Yeah, I don't blame you. You were freaking there towards the end, too. Those guys.
Can you blame me? It's a bomb.
You want to get back in?
No!
Get back in just
do
for a minute.
No. Do another
get
minute.
Back in for
no.
a minute.
No. Do another
no.
minute.
No.
Please,
no.
Earl.
No!
I don't want to go in.
Listen, no, let him go. Let him go. They're always ready to throw someone in the coffin.
No. Oh, God. Earl, you just stink.
I wish we
you
had
do.
This.
You stink like formaldehyde.
I smell like death!
Now, here's the weird thing, Fezzy. After the show today, you're flying back to Florida?
Yeah.
So you have two major fears in the same day.
Oh, yeah. Basically, two coffins. One that happens to fly.
Flying coffin. Which, when you think about it, that tube is not much different.
No. And that's what the other passengers want. Someone who has the smell of death on them as they make their way down the aisle.
You're not going to be able to get rid of that formaldehyde smell.
No. There's no way. I would have to hang outside the plane to air myself out.
You know what you need to do, too, when you leave an Earl, you get in with him. Take a bath of Listerine. I'll fill up a tub of Listerine and lay in it. Right up to your chin. Earl, when you were in there, did you try to jack off for a second?
No.
Tell me, because I heard something. It's not like...
It was my like, fist hitting the top of the coffin.
I thought you were jacking off. USF drops last night, so Fez is getting in the coffin. Now, if you go to Pal Talk, the Ron and Fez showroom, you'll be able to see this. Or you can go to the other room, and French will be in there. All right, Fez, looks like about that time. You're going to mosey on over.
Ronnie, I can't go in there.
Mosey on over and get in that room.
I can't get in that casket. I can't.
Look, Earl got in the casket. It was nothing for him. He got in. He laid down. They shut the lid. He felt comfortable.
He fainted twice. I can still smell the thing from here. It's going to be closed. I'm going to be in there for a couple of hours.
Fez. Earl fainted twice watching 30 Rock. He faints. You can't go by him. He faints.
Oh, man. I just can't do it right. Please do not make me go in there. I can't do it.
Earl, where's Mikey background? I thought he was making the scene today.
He's coming in a little bit later.
Why don't you do this, Fez? You get in there. We shut the lid. 2 hours later, we let you out. It's that simple.
I mean, I know it's that simple, and it sounds that simple, but the hard part is being inside it for 2 hours.
I just thought of something, too. What if you have a heart attack in there? That's what I worry about.
Yeah, I worry about that, too. I'm sure my blood pressure's pretty high right now.
The only good thing is if, God forbid, you die, we got you in the perfect box for it. And you're on Pal Talk, and that takes care of the viewing.
I'm just looking at it right now, and I cannot go in that thing. I can't see myself doing it.
Would you feel better knowing that you're going to be duct taped in there?
No, that wouldn't make me feel any better.
Oh, I thought that would make you feel cozier.
No, it's not going to make me feel secure in that sense.
You know what you could do while you're in there? I'll give you a pad and pen, and you write a fezitorial. This is my fezitorial. Thank you.
I'm not going to be able to even see in there.
Oh, that's true.
It's going to be dark. That lid's going to be right up against my face.
All right.
It's going to stink. It's going to be hot.
Why don't you do this? I always believe in like a fantasy thing. You put yourself in the best role that you are, you know? And like a lot of times, like if you're getting dental work done, the whole time you're in there, think about the beach. You're out on the beach. You're riding waves. And all of a sudden, your mind is so powerful, you will go there. When you lay in that casket, fantasize that you're dead and that there's dirt being thrown on top of it and you're going to be there for eternity.
That's not a good fantasy. That's basically what's happening. I'll be in a coffin.
You want to just go to over and just be next to it so you know you can dive right in?
I just want to forget about the whole thing. I just want it to go away.
Everybody expects you to get in a coffin.
I understand, but I mean, I think people would understand seeing this if they were in the room with the casket. They saw how bad it was for Earl. I don't see where I'm going to be much better. I'm totally claustrophobic. I can't stand the thought of that lid shutting.
Did you think of any of these things before you made your bet?
I really didn't think I was going to lose the bet.
See, that's the problem.
That's as far as the thinking process went.
That's the problem with gamblers. They only envision winning. I swear to God, I've never even bought a lottery ticket without spending some of the money. While I'm sitting there, I'm thinking to myself, well, this is going to be great news for my parents, obviously. It never occurs to me. It's that there's a little bit of hope with every bet. That's what people who don't bet can understand. That there'll be a couple moments of belief.
I mean, there was times last night, even when, you know, USF was down, where I still thought, all right, this is a wacky enough game. I'm going to come back and win this thing. I never thought about getting in that casket.
Well, you did lose the game.
I mean, I understand. I mean, there's going to be other games. There's pro games this weekend.
You won't see them. You'll be in a coffin.
Not the entire weekend.
Oh. By the way, while you're in there, I found out we're all getting ice cream.
Great.
That makes it even worse.
Now it's just painful as well as scary.
Time for you to go, man.
I can't do it. I cannot, Ronnie. I can't do it, and nobody can make me do it.
You're
I can't go in.
Dead man walking.
No, I can't go in that thing. It is a mess.
Yeah, it's bad. It's a casket.
Yeah.
But here's something. You're not going to have to stand up in there. You get to lay down. I'm basically saying you're going to get to do nothing for the next 2 hours.
I know, but it's nothing like I'm dead. It's nothing like, and I can't get out. Even if I wanted to get out of doing nothing, I couldn't get out of it. Once that thing's shut.
Here we go, Fez. Stand and deliver.
I can't stand. I can't even stand up to go near it.
Earl, you did it. It wasn't so bad, right?
It's horrible. What do you mean it wasn't that bad?
Horrible or good?
Horrible.
See? And Earl has a healthy heart.
Here's Jake. Jake, you're on Run of Fez.
Yo, Fezzy, maybe you'd feel better if we gave you the Kill Bill Advantage, a flashlight and a straight razor, man.
I wouldn't give him a straight razor in there. I would not do that.
I don't want the razor. I don't even know if I would want the flashlight where I was seeing myself in there.
Why don't you try to punch yourself? That 6-inch punch I taught you. Remember when I taught you that? You thought I was being mean?
Right.
This is the reason why.
I had no idea.
You're going to be able to punch yourself out and then dig through the dirt. What kind of sick fuck even writes that scene? Because digging through the dirt 6 feet, I don't think you can do it.
Yeah, it's horrible.
No, there's too much pressure there.
Here's Wally in Northern Virginia. Hello, Wally.
Hi, Ron. This is Wally from Northern Virginia Hills Cemetery. And just say the word and we'll send up the truck, just like you requested and paid for. We appreciate your business, Mr. Bennington.
Oh, so funny, Wally. Good one.
Everybody thinks adorable. Everybody thinks they can do this.
Yeah, exactly. He's holding on the line. They are going to just freak.
I know. Everyone thinks they're going to be our friend with one bad phone call.
Where do they fall out?
Yeah. All right, here you go, big man.
I can't go in there, Ronnie. I swear, I'm just begging to you, as my friend, please don't make me go in there. I can't do it.
Fez.
Yes?
You don't have to do it. But do you want to do it? Do you want to be the guy who pulled off the stunt? Why don't we do this? Take a break.
All right.
We'll come back and think about it. All right?
Okay, that's fair.
We'll do a quick break here. When we're back, it's coffin time. Ron and Fez show. Fezzy, it is that time to, as they say, pay the piper. You had the bet. The coffin is here. People are ready for you to hop in that coffin for the rest of the show.
Ronnie, I don't see how I can do this. I mean, I thought about it during the break, you know, and I just don't see how I can get in there.
Think about the lid shut on you.
That's the part that makes me not want to do it.
Think about the lack of air.
I don't like that part either. There's a lot of things, there's a lot of negatives against this.
Yeah.
On the pros and cons list, the cons are just overwhelming.
You ready to do this, Fez?
No, I am not ready. I can't go in there.
It's just a coffin.
I know, but it's going to be dark. It's going to be hot.
Just think of it this way. I'm going to be right out here with all this air. Think about me breathing, walking around, doing what I want.
The more I think about someone else breathing, the less I'll be able to concentrate on me breathing.
Life is going on.
The more I'll think, you know what? I'm not breathing.
All right, now you can view Fez in the coffin from the Pal Talk room.
Ron and Fez showroom.
Yeah. All right, here we go, big man.
I can't. I swear to you, I can't do it.
You need a little help? You want me to have the boys force you in?
No, I don't want Pepper and Dave shoving me in there like they did to Earl.
Come on, big man.
I just can't do it. I can't do it. Would like to do it, can't do it.
I don't think that music's helping him right now, Earl.
No.
He's at a scary point now.
No, you're playing the theme song from the guy who's in Buried Alive matches on the WWE.
Yeah. Pull that down. Are you ready to do this, Fez?
No, I am not. I can't go in there. I just can't. I can't make myself get up and go in there.
Mikey boy, will they ever forgive us if he doesn't get in?
No. Absolutely not.
And that's Mikey boy. That's not me saying it.
I know. And Mikey boy's really nice, and he's just being honest.
Fez, you don't have to get in there. You don't have to. But then you're the guy who didn't do the stunt everybody was waiting for.
Right.
You can be that guy. That's where you are right now. You're at a crossroads. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
And you know, there's some people are like, and when this happened, they're like, Fez will not do this. He won't follow through. But here's the thing, ladies and gentlemen. You don't know this man the way I do. I've seen him in a G-string in public. I've seen him in a giant manatee costume with people throwing heads of lettuce at him. I've seen the stuff he's done in the past.
It's true.
This is not just Fez Watley. This is Fez motherfucking Watley, a goddamn legend in this business, Fez. And there's an old saying, you live fast, You die young, you leave a good looking corpse. Well, you blew that. You had that opportunity in 94, and you lived.
Right.
Now you can do it one more time. One more time you can shock people. And you can be the big cat. And you can walk down that aisle the way you did so many times before and show these folks your Fez motherfucking Watley. You're the big cat. There ain't a stunt in the history of radio that you can't pull off. I know it, and you know it. Yeah, you lost the step. I'm not going to lie to you. You lost the step. You got a couple stents in your chest.
Yeah.
But you're still Fez Watley. You're still the legend. Now, you can back away from this, and I'll fight everybody with you. I'll battle them all day after day in this. Or you can be the man and walk and lay in that coffin and show them all. Do something Earl couldn't do. All these young guys would not do it. One after another. Dave, Hicks, they couldn't do it. But they don't have your history, my man. They ain't been to the places you've been before. They haven't seen the sights you've seen. It's up to you, big cat. What are you going to do?
I'm going to get in the coffin.
Yeah! And Fezzy, you're going to lay in that coffin, right? But here's what's going to get up. You're going to bury your fears. You're going to get out of there and your fears are going to stay behind.
All right.
There he goes. Now put on the Undertaker music now. And he'll walk proudly. Don't touch him, Dave. He'll walk on his own. He spits in the eye of death. He's the big cat. He's Fez Watley.
It is so damn hot.
You know
what?
I know
it's going to be hot in there.
Strip it down, big cat. Strip it down.
Does anyone mind?
No, strip it down. Work for you heat. Sure? Fuck David Blaine. Fuck David Blaine. Look at you. Fear is dead as of today. We bury fear today, Fez. We bury fear. Off comes the shirt. How about the shoes, big man?
Yeah, totally.
Taking off the shoes. Taking off the shoes. Get him a mic.
Yeah, I'm just taking the jeans off, too.
Get out of the jeans.
It's just all too hot.
All right, boxers and a wife beater.
There we go.
You know what? Take a second, lay down and acclimate yourself before we shut it.
Oh, man.
Acclimate yourself. Come on over here, boys. Be next to him. You're his pallbearers. Fez Watley. Laying in the coffin as we speak, facing his fear. And look at...
Oh, it stinks. Oh my God, it stinks.
You know what? Here's the thing with boxes, Fez. You might not want to wear them that high. You might want to bring them down just a little bit. Get them off the armpits. Give your armpits a little room.
And who tucks a shirt into boxers?
He tucks his undershirt into his boxers.
You don't tuck all into right. boxers.
I'm dealing with a nut here.
This is one of your social problems.
Jeez.
There's no point of wearing boxers if you're going to tuck in the undershirt.
All right, here he goes.
I don't even know how to get in.
You know, just get in like you're getting into a coffin. Look, he acts like he's getting off a boat. Like he's got scuba gear on.
Like I gotta get into a pool or something.
Oh, they respect you now, Fez. Oh!
Oh my God.
All right, easy. He's stuffing himself in there.
I think a gnat came out. Careful.
He is stuffing himself in
Be
there.
Be careful on Pal Talk.
You know what?
To pixelate it.
Why, we have a couple seconds. You want Hicks to take a razor to those shoulders? And just knock some of the hair down?
No, I'm fine, thank you.
Alright, just how does it feel laying in there?
Oh God, it's awful.
Alright, turn and face the camera, they want to see your face.
Hi everyone.
Oh, look at the big cat, how you feeling?
I feel awful. This thing is 10 times tighter than I thought it would be.
Just think of it as a very tight coffin.
Yeah. Oh, thanks.
Look at you.
It feels You're like doing more than Earl. That I have to wear.
Earl, how do you feel right now? This man who's twice your age has laid in a coffin. And let me tell you something. This is the bravery of the big cat. He's going to be in that coffin sooner rather than later. So he knows what he's dealing with. Look at his hair. Look at his little hand shaking.
I know. It's awful.
Come on, BC.
I just...
All right, now what we're going to do is just close the bottom lid.
It's
just the bottom lid.
It's weird knowing that this is the view everyone's going to have one day.
Not me, brother. Me. I ain't even going to go to your funeral.
What?
I can't see you in a fucking crate. This is too much for me. Oh, God, that really does break my heart a little bit, because that is what they do. They always have the bottom of the casket done. So how's that feel knowing that the bottom's out, Fez?
I don't like it. Yeah. Because, like, you know, I can touch the top, the bottom of the lid with my feet.
Yeah. Should we tie your ankles together so you don't have to deal with it?
No, don't do that. No.
What are you doing with my mic?
Oh, no, that was just the headphones. I didn't realize it was yours. I thought it was mine.
Jesus Christ, he drives me nuts. All right.
I know. I mean, could we at least admit the wrong person's in this casket today?
Well, Fuzzy, you know, you did pick the bums of USF. All right, take his microphone.
Oh, man.
And just relax, Fuzzy.
God, it smells like a black guy was in here.
You know, there's no sense of being... Your last words shouldn't be racist.
No.
But put the fucking mic up on the stand there. And we should be able to hear you from in the coffin. Now, the people on Pal Talk know that he is laying in an actual coffin.
That's so creepy. That's the creepiest thing I've ever seen in my life.
The corpse just waved.
The corpse.
What are you supposed to do? I don't know. There's etiquette.
His eyes even look dead to me.
All right.
Don't say that.
Well, you kind of look dead.
All right, Fezzy. I'm going to have Pitsy just take the top of the box. He's not going to do anything yet, but just know that he's there. Don't even pull it up too far. How's that feel to you, Fez?
It feels awful, Ronnie.
Put the fucking mic on him so we can hear him.
It feels awful. It is the worst feeling in the world.
All right, just take your time to breathe now, because you're not going to have a lot of breathing later.
Oh, man.
The breaths are going to be bad. All right, so take your time, acclimate yourself, and know that you're going to be lowered into the ground. All right, Fez, how you feel now? Have you calmed down?
No. It's like boiling up inside of me.
And
the crazy thing is, the only way to hold your arms in here is across your chest.
Oh, jeez.
That's the only way to do it. There's no room to have them any other way.
See, that's my problem with caskets. You need a little room. I'd like to have enough room and a TV in there. All right, we're going to start and put the top up over. Just a little bit, Fez. We're not going to lower it yet.
Yeah, don't shut it yet. I'm not ready for it to be shut.